Invisibobble.
Invisibobble.
Go, go. Yes, yes.
Invisibobble.
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 Yes!
Invisibobble!
The successful Danish 27-year-old Sophie is the inventor of the traceless hair ties, the Invisibobble hair elastic that keeps hair secure without breaking it or tangling, is sold in 70 countries. She's on the Forbes list 30 under 30, and she's going to share her story with our podcast listeners today. I'm so proud to have such a young and inspiring guest, who hopefully will inspire many more out there to believe in their own dreams and starting their own business. Please welcome Sophie Trelis, a strong and powerful woman, to another episode of Road to Success.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. So you invested 3,000 euros in an idea that you had only because you had a drink, a vodka tonic. Do you believe that you would still have the same idea with the hair tie if there was no college party and no vodka tonic? So this is my question, because your success story is so inspiring and there was alcohol involved, and maybe with my gin tonics, I'll come up with a great idea.
The quick answer is no, I don't think there would have been Invisibobble without alcohol involved and this party. Because this is all, that was, I guess, the moment which caused me to even think about having an idea to start a business. And then the last thing I did before I went to the party was I took an old telephone cord, which was from an old telephone inside my dorm room at university. I put it in my hair, went to the party, and then woke up the next day. And the first thing I realized was that it didn't really give me a headache, even though I still had a bit of a hangover and so on. And the first thing I did then was to pick up the phone and call my boyfriend and say, hey, I have an idea for a business.
How would you describe success then, now knowing that you're also listed on the Forbes list, Dear Sophie, which is a huge success, and you also have your hair ties in 70 countries. Is that success to you?
For me, success is when you have done something that helps the customer, I guess. And we see this with our Invisibobbles. People write me also on my personal account on Instagram and say how I have changed their life and so on. And then I always think like, oh, it's a bit exaggerated to say that I've changed someone's life for the better with something as small as a hair tie. We have had situations when we started, we were really, really young. We were actually 18 when we started, and then I was 19 when we had our first products on the market. And what happened very often was that people at trade shows, for example, didn't want to talk to us because we looked so young that they thought we were the interns or the people handing out flyers. And then they said, no, I don't want to talk to you. I will wait to talk to your boss, which was our head of sales or something like this, which is why as well, at some point we lied about our age. So when we were 19, we were pretending to be 22 because that just sounded a little bit better.
It actually does. I have another question. As I know that you're Scandinavian, I heard about this one law, this unwritten law, which is Jente Loven. And I wanted to ask you how you feel about that, because I heard that being different and standing out is like not acceptable in that culture. And what you have reached so far is like beyond everything. So was that ever a problem to you?
I strive to be anything but vanilla. What does vanilla mean? Vanilla,
plain Jane.
Vanilla flavored ice cream is a flavor that everybody likes. It's no one's favorite. Mm-hmm. It's just okay. And to live your life by being just okay means that you're normal, it means that you're average, and it means that you do what everybody else is doing. And I don't really care what it is that I do that is different. Sometimes it can also be different in a negative way, but I always strive to be different